The Construction and Engineering Digest Magazine CED organized Constructive Conversation Platform hosted Dr. Larry Tari Koka in Lagos as he speaks on the theme Architecture Methodology and a Catalyst for Economic Development. Still under Dr. Larry Tari Koka, Basharun J.K. Randu speaks on the professional and his contribution to the built environment and Nigeria. 1004 Estate Limited CEO speaks on the facility management in Nigeria and the value of 1004 estates to this sector. Plus, Engineer Otis Ayeji, Fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers and President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, speaks on his 1 year in office as President of the largest professional body in Nigeria. Plus, other interesting issues on business, finance and the economy. This is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Hello, a very good day to you and thanks for joining us. This is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Today we are starting something very new that CED Magazine has put together. Constructive Conversation is a platform to discuss issues that is burning in Nigeria and also development issues that will grow Nigeria and the economy. It was hosted by CED Magazine and architect Larry Tari Koka was on the hot seat to discuss the issue. We'll talk about all that when we come back right after this commercial break. This is Inside Business Africa. Stay with us. Welcome back. He's still Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Dr. Larry Tari Koka was recently elected into the prestigious fellowship of the Royal Institute of British Architects. He's the only and the first Nigerian to be so elected, and also he is among the 30 of the over 100 years old global body. Very significant achievement indeed. It was against the backdrop that CED Magazine, in collaboration with Inside Business Africa, hosted him to a very important platform known as Constructive Conversation to talk about architecture and methodology as catalyst for economic development. Inside Business Africa was there. Here's the report. The importance of architecture in this present economy in which Nigeria seeks her rightful position in the already emerged 21st century global economy cannot be overemphasized, since the quality of human habitat and environment revolves around architecture. Therefore, architecture education in the country has to raise its standard to foster students' creativity and strengthen their interest, motivation and commitment to improve the environment, since Nigeria continuously needs to compete in knowledge, development and innovation economy. It is against the backdrop of the importance of architecture in stimulating economic development that Constructive Conversation, a CED Magazine's platform, held the first edition in the series in 2017 in honor of Dr. Larry Tari Koka, FRIBA, FNRA, PhD, who was recently elected Fellow of the prestigious Royal Institute of British Architects, RIBA, the first and only Nigerian to be so elected into the 30 Global Fellow of RIBA. It is also of note that Dr. Larry Tari Koka was one-time Commissioner of Housing, Lagos State, and has written two books on housing development in Nigeria. The event, held at Four Points by Sheraton, Victoria Island, Lagos, attracted dignitaries from the built environment and the business community, including Basharun J.K. Rangdu, architect Tony Oliver Braid, President of the Nigerian Institute of Architects, representative of Engineer Ami Maseli, CEO M Group of Companies, among others. The program started with a short welcome speech by Mr. Kenneth Odushola Stevenson, the Chief Executive Officer, Century 21 Systems Communications Limited, the organizers of the events.
And the quality of people you know, we also reflect in your bank account. So if you move around the right people and do what is right, you won't be recognized. And I think that is a major achievement. And To that extent, we would like to congratulate him once again. And also, we have decided to put a publication in the honor. And that publication is available here now. And so that whatever you are able to listen to here, you can also go with a transcript of that in the publication.
Thereafter, the president of the Nigerian Institute of Architects, Architect Tonye Breed, spoke on the honor Dr. Lanre Tarikoka has brought to the country, being the first Nigerian to be elected fellow of the Royal Institute of British Architects, welcoming all the distinguished guests to the event and appreciating Dr. Lanre Tarikoka for accepting to greet the occasion and congratulating him on his new election as the fellow of the Royal Institute of British Architects.
Our Nigerian citizen, Lanre Tarikoka, is one of 30 recognized by the RIB. It's something that will give us great joy and pleasure. Our institute had always been very dynamic and had also been able to pick up some international laurels in the past, also able to contribute a president to the International Union of Architects. Sometime in the past. And thereafter, we also had the president of the AUA, African Union of Architects. Before, you know, like every good thing, you have nine, you have the eight, we went into a little bit of some airships. But we are in the process of a reformation. And we are very much encouraged that there is a big beacon of hope that we can see in the person of Dr. Lanre Tarikoka. We are very sure that this is the beginning of greater things to come for Nigeria. This is the beginning of a big renaissance that we are going to get back into. A reawakening of learning, we will stop the random chase for inflated contracts, adding multiple zeros to construction projects, getting amount of budgets that right now the power price has also, or not the power price, the foreign exchange has also added its own zeros. We are not able to complete most of those projects. We now have to look and listen to people who should be able to come up with the right critical thinking that this country needs. We need to be able to mobilize our best brains. We need to be able to have people who shall set the pace, who shall become role models. And we're very happy that the Nigerian Institute of Architects and the entire Republic of Nigeria, we have found it in the person of Lanre Tarikoka. We want to give him a special round of applause. And we also want to say that maybe in partnership with the construction magazine, CED, we should see whether we can have a repeat performance of this at national level. Because you know, we need to bring the right political interface. The right political interface for them to realize that part of the solution to the problem which we are facing now may lie in architecture. We ourselves must be able to re-engineer ourselves and be ready and get the right guidance to start the process. It's been said and there's been a lot of accusation that there's been a lot of infiltration of people, foreign architects coming, they get people start to join this and that and that. The issue has been that if you leave your doors open, then there will be room for people to come in. We still have many empty seats here, so many people can still walk in here and sit down. But if the seats are full, there will be no space for people to come in. I tell you a story. We went to watch a movie the other day over the Christmas period, Silverbed Cinema. I remember when I was a little boy, we used to have this cinema, big cinema screen, open air. It used to be a great event, you know, as a little primary school boy to go and watch cinema. And after that, cinema died in Nigeria for a very long time. And that cinema being revived. And in Abuja, you won't believe it. Over Christmas, I couldn't believe it. We had to stand in a line. We had to wait for 2 hours because the theater was full. If we have built up the right capacity to engage government, to engage in the projects that are there, wonderful projects, as we can see, it's just one man who has shown excellence and he is doing it. If he was not there, we don't have people from South America, people from South Africa, people from Australia, and so on. So you need to build up capacity. And that is what we hope. We still very strong and agile. We believe that for the next few months I still have as president, will engage him, sir, on month-to-month basis to see how we can build from existing capacity. Because when you don't have encouragement, when there is no hope for the future, even that which you know will start to evaporate. And that is the problem we are facing. And that is why we are not able to take the right position in getting architecture to be the main catalyst, not at once, of our economic reconstruction and economic development. It has happened all over the world. It's not rocket science. Architecture is something that we all know we can do it. And it said that the quality of a country is judged by its architecture. Well, let me say the quality of its buildings. And I think with people like Dr. Larry Nawe Koka, there is hope, there's great hope that we can be able to reconstruct our future. Thank you very much.
The conversation, anchored by Oni Nwangu Stevenson, took the live television format. Since the event was broadcast live on Facebook, had Dr. Larry Tarikoka to lead discourse and spoke on the theme, Architectural Design and Methodology as Catalyst for Economic Development. He started the conversation on his background and his journey into becoming who he is today.
Being one of 30, only 30 in the world, I think is a singular honor for Nigeria, actually, not just for myself. I couldn't have done it without being in Nigeria.
Dr. Koka stated that one of the things that made him to be consistent was the zeal to succeed no matter what. Stating the difference between Nigerian architects and the British architects, Dr. Koka said Nigerian architects lack opportunity, exposure and continuity, while the British architects have all this.
The RIBA, Royal Institution, has contributed in many ways to lots of other institutions around the world. Same thing in South Africa. Every Commonwealth country, I believe, was the local institutes were initiated by the RIBA, and we led the campaign to expel South Africa from the Commonwealth Association of Architects. During the time of apartheid, there was not one single African architect in South Africa, as our time it was. And incidentally, the first South African African architect I met in 1994, and this was a lady.
Speaking on the theme, he said architecture could be the stimulant for economic development in Nigeria if only the government can appreciate these facts and act on it as part of the strategic initiatives to get Nigeria's economy out of the current economic predicaments.
Progress without architecture. You look at the ancient civilizations, Egyptians, you still see their
Speaking further, Dr. Larry Tarikoka stated that it's the responsibility of the state and local governments, not the federal government, to develop houses that will be affordable for low-income earners nationally. He also emphasized the need to have more building projects in order to provide more employment and more economic activities in the country.
So now, once that state or province sent its requirements to the federal level in Pretoria, the federal level in Pretoria would allocate the exact amount of money for the number of units that it said needed.
The conversation was also open to the distinguished guests at the event, all emphasizing on the importance of Nigerian government to take architecture professional.
Then they asked you about environmental standards. That's when they riddled it down to the next model. And the final thing was the design. It was at the point that we did the design that they flew from Washington to tell us that we had won the competition.
Talking about the person of Dr. Larry Tarikoka, Adabashorin J.K. Randall is a very renowned accountant in Nigeria. and I'm sure many of us are familiar with him, and he was able to share his thoughts with Inside Business Africa about the person of Dr. Lanre Tarikoka, his contribution to the built environment and Nigeria.
I think I've known him for almost 60 years, and so I think I can vouch for his outstanding talents. His combination of being a creative person combined with his business acumen and his tenacity of purpose. He's always been very well focused and he's very competitive, as he himself has publicly declared. And far more interesting is the fact that he's achieved this unique
Well, indeed, congratulations to Dr. Lanre Tarikoka. When we come back right after this commercial break, we'll be talking about 1004 Estates. It's a facility management organization that was actually managing the 1004 Estates in Lagos. The managing director has been sharing his thoughts about the experience he had and also what he's been able to contribute to the facility management sector in Nigeria. We'll talk about all that when we come back right after this commercial break. How would you like your construction and engineering industry news and information? Broad, complex and difficult to read? Or sharp, ready to read and explore? Presenting Construction and Engineering Digest Magazine CED, refreshing clarity in construction and engineering industry news and information. Construction and Engineering Digest Magazine CED, incorporating oil and gas report with news and information that work for you. Welcome back. You're still Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Indeed, the facility management sector in Nigeria may be new, but quite a number of organizations are breaking new grounds in bringing this particular sector to the limelight. 1004 Estates Limited actually was an organization set up, a facility management organization set up to manage the 1004, providing the value addition to that particular estate. The managing director has been speaking with Inside Business on his experience and also what the particular organization is doing to make sure that estate get top class facility management services.
The truth is that the recession is going to have an impact on property development, just the same way it impacts so many parts of our lives. You know, there's been a high cost of increase in prices in the economy, fuel price, price for gas, the dollar value has, you know. Well, basically, you know, property business is like most other businesses, you know. You require a certain amount of skill and amount of training to actually, you know, bring out the best in a recession. The recession brings out the best of the managers. So you don't expect somebody who is not in petroleum business to be able to go and, you know, manage a petroleum business in recession. So property owners have to, first of all, put a lot of emphasis on making sure they have the professional people to first and foremost manage their property. Well, I think that's really good. It's a landmark, you know, case because of the size of what we're talking about here. We are convinced that takeover was illegal, not in accordance with the constitution of the country. The constitution guarantees the right to own and manage property of individuals and companies anywhere in this country. That is a constitutional provision. We are also quite aware that the action that was taken is not in consonance with the judgment of Justice Daudu, where we sued the resident association for interfering in the management. Yeah, the outlook was quite bleak in 2016. Like I told you, there was just that mental adjustment and even the shock of the rapid fall in the Naira. Not many projects were stopped. Many projects did not complete. I think now some projects are beginning to spring up. But you can also remember that we had a lot of completed projects, office buildings, commercial buildings, even the retail section, the shop ride, the shopping mall and the mini malls, you see springing up now. They appear to be doing well. But in terms of the office sector, we have a lot of office space sitting down, and they are all A-class office buildings.
Well, our special report on the facility management sector in Nigeria will continue from next week on Inside Business Africa, as we'll be talking with so many of the organizations that are offering these particular services to Nigeria. It's very key. Maintenance is important, and we'll be focusing on that in association with CED Magazine. When we come back right after this commercial break, we'll go talk about engineering, and especially Nigeria Society of Engineers, and who's been managing the affairs of the organization in the last 1 year. We'll talk about that when we come back right after this commercial break. Still Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Thanks for staying with us. Engineer Otis Ayeji, and since that 1 year ago, he has actually brought to that particular association an unprecedented performance recognition, and also making it one of the most important associations in Nigeria, especially when it comes to the issue of infrastructure. In the last 1 year also, he has been able to bridge several gaps, bringing the association to the limelight like it was. But today we are talking about this particular personality, because on his own part, his organization, Otis Engineering, has done successfully well by positioning the organization and consulting to build 10 power plants in Nigeria in the last 10 years, and it's been delivered. To that extent, he's an experienced engineer. Today we are having him on this hot seat to talk about his experience in this special documentary on Engineer Otis Ayeji, 1 year as president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. A year ago, precisely January 16, 2016, Engineer Otis Oliver Ayeji, fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, was sworn in as the president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, the largest professional body in Nigeria with strong vision and determination to transform the association and make meaningful contributions to the development of engineering and the economy of Nigeria. The last 1 year, no doubt, has been an eventful year for the Nigerian Society of Engineers, as Engineer Otis Ayeji succeeded in bridging the necessary bridge across the engineering world, the public and the private sector, and the development professionals that ensure critically recognized and tremendous milestones were recorded. The achievement of Engineer Otis Ayeji, president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, a consummate and integrity-driven professional of repute, has brought with it goodwill for the profession and the practitioners. The decision to become the president of NSE must have been born out of years of desires that make meaningful contributions to the profession and the industry. In the last 1 year, therefore, has the desire been worthwhile given the performance in the last 1 year, and what are some of the specific milestones that could be referred to as eventful?
It's been more than worthwhile. I had lost the ambition to desire to become the president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers way back in the early 90s. But the journey took rather quite a long time, from 1991-92 down to 2013, when I eventually won to become president-elect. deputy president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. And so one must say that it was clear in my mind what those things are that I wanted to achieve as president of the society. I certainly place high on my agenda the issue of advocacy to promote and advance the interests of the profession.
Doing good is one thing, and getting people to appreciate the good and eventful performance is another. For the eventful and unprecedented 1 year of service to the profession and the country, what has been the response of the members to the various changes and dynamism that has been brought to the Nigerian Society of Engineers by his leadership?
By and large, I'm getting the cooperation of members, and of course, one will not shy away from the various dimensions of the programs, you know, we are working on. For example, one of the first measures we, you know, brought about is about the management of the society, and of course using the secretariat structure. And we had identified even long before we got there that the management structure in use was non-responsive to the needs of the profession.
Again, the achievement is expected to put the government on edge, especially the fact that various sectors of the economy, one way or the other, is impacted by engineering, and members of the body also cut across all sectors. How much of these performances have gotten the government's attention and the desired results sought?
I love the president's speech for one reason, and that reason is that the president also floated a motto. You know, we talk about change begins with me.
Yes.
Yeah, but change begins with me is not a scaling kind of statement. You can't measure change. It's kind of subjective. But there is a statement the president made in his budget presentation where he said that what we need, we must produce.
Yes.
Which India really adopted at the time of independence, 1948. That, yes, what that's Nehru,
yes,
Pandit Nehru. That Jawaharlal Nehru, yes. What you need, you produce.
Yes.
What you don't produce, you don't
use
need.
Yes.
You don't use it, yes. So that also is what we have to do. And then recession will be a thing of the past.
Engineer Otis Ayinji's private sector experience may have contributed to his unprecedented performance 1 year on as president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, the largest professional body in Nigeria, from petroleum, electrical, civil to agricultural engineering, among others. This experience also put him in the best position to understand public-private partnership models and the power sector, where he has acted as consultant on the NIPP projects for which 10 power plants have been delivered. Therefore, 3 years ago, there was a major shift in the power sector when the federal government sold the DISCO and the Genco to the private sector operators, which put lots of power for the sector in the hands of the private sector. Engineer Otis has this to say about the sector since the privatization and the status of the sector today.
I had defined engineering earlier when I said that engineering is the application of the sciences to the solution of human problems in an ethical, safe, economical, healthy, and environmentally friendly manner. And that means that engineering, in all that it does to create the various products and systems and processes that runs human communities.
Specifically, getting Nigeria out of recession, which the federal government say is the key point of the 2017 budget, and engineering and economic prosperity, what is the position of engineers in all these, and how could the country tap into the capacity of engineers to ensure growth and shared value, we ask.
We will continue with our advocacy. Like today you saw, we had to take on the issue of the closure of Abuja Airport, which we say is awful. Nobody talks about that in the civilized world, so we shouldn't. Engineering has ways of doing that without closing the place. And we insist that will be done. Look, Nigerians can do it. Nigerians have done it during the Civil War. The federal forces bombed the airport every night, and the other side received supplies from that same airport every night.
The remaining 1 year, no doubt, will be more eventful given the performance in 1 year. Again, the fact that the country must get out of the recession and investment in infrastructure is key, which is basically engineering based, must be at the front burner of governments at all levels. Engineer Otis Ayenji speaks on his vision for the remaining 1 year and the NSC in the next 5 years.
Well, the state of the nation, we thank God we've been able to put down the insurgency aspects. We hope also with the new movements by the government that the militancy side also will be contained, and we should be able to now establish an economy that is productive, that is based on this one-liner I was hailing the president for.
Yes.
And that Inside Business Africa is also talking about business, finance, and the economy of Nigeria, and that several things will be happening in the next couple of weeks. And indeed, you will want to stay tuned to the program every time on Inside Business Africa to get the best of information on business, finance, and the economy. Congratulations, Engineer Otis Ayenji. It's been Kenneth Odusola Stevenson presenting. Thank you again for watching. See you next time.